I just visited Bukit Brown Cemetery, and I think I may have seen something I wasn't supposed to see.
There was a hut behind, and people used to do black magic there, so we'll check it out later. What the fuck? Oh, hi, sorry.
Sorry.
Get out, get out. We saw a lady dressed in white just peek out.
This was truly an unforgettable night for me.
I'm now at Bukit Brown Cemetery and I'm going to be exploring this place alone. Other than my cameraman, it's literally just the two of us. I've heard so many stories and you guys have even asked me to come to this place. I brought my ghost gear and we're going to go inside. Let's see if we find anything, if spirits even do exist.
Bukit Brown Cemetery is home to more than 100,000 graves, many of which are nestled in the thick of the forest. And it is one of Singapore's oldest cemeteries, with the first grave dating back to 1833. This place is rich with history, with many of Singapore's pioneers having their graves buried within these grounds. So I was honored to be here. However, this cemetery is allegedly one of the most haunted places in Singapore. There have been numerous sightings of Pontianaks lurking in the shadows of the surrounding forest. In fact, it is said that there are multiple Pontianaks haunting the area. In 2021, a now famous photo made its rounds on the internet, which showed three friends taking a selfie in Bukit Brown Cemetery, but with an extra companion. Is this the hand of a Pontianak? Or was there something trying to give them a hand in taking a better quality photo? Furthermore, 2018 saw the opening of a new massive 8-lane highway that was to directly cut through Bukit Brown Cemetery, which resulted in 4,000 graves being exhumed. This is said to have angered the spirits of Bukit Brown Cemetery, who were supposed to be resting eternally within this burial place. Whatever I thought I was walking into, I was not prepared for this unforgettable night.
So we are in Bukit Brown Cemetery now. I wonder why there's so many lights in front here. Let's check it out. Another caution sign, enter your own risk. This is a nice little shrine. Wow. Let's keep walking. Also, if you're wondering why I'm dressed so nicely, like I'm wearing dress pants, it's because of the sponsor of today's video, Thousand Miles, thank you. This looks like dress pants, but it's actually not. It's made of freaking sports material. But more on that later. Let's keep walking. I got my EMF reader. Just turned it on, but nothing here so far. So far from my experience in cemeteries, EMF readers don't really light up that well because there are no electrical wires here in cemeteries. As you can see, there are no lights. So there's a grave over there, as you can see. Yeah, we are just walking among graves right now. It's literally a pitch black road, as you can see. Pitch black. Can't see shit. Is there anything here? So the EMF was spiking for a bit just now. Is anyone following us? Hello. We mean you no harm. Just taking a walk. Is there anything following us? Anything here? Did something touch this EMF just now? Can you come and touch it again? Maybe it got shy. Let's keep going. It went to tree bars just now. Like every time when we turn on the camera, the EMF just stops. Anything around here following us? Cheekily following us? If there's anything, can you come and touch this EMF reader again? Make it go up? It's just whenever we turn on the camera, it just stops. It's okay, take your time. We'll still be here for another 2 hours. 1 hour, 2 hours. Thank you. Wanna go in there? We're gonna go in. It says enter at your own risk. You're in a closed cemetery.
So some parts of the cemetery are nestled in the thick of the forest, which I do not recommend going in the dead of night as you could easily get lost. Like, look at this. We are literally in a jungle.
There's a small grave there. Tiny one there. The trees are all down. I wonder if this was made on purpose. Like, are we not supposed to go in there? Let's go slightly further in. There are so many paths in here, like if you make just one wrong turn, you could easily get lost in here. Like look, there's another path here. I think it's because people are finding new graves, because not every grave has been discovered, because it's literally a cemetery hidden in the thick of a forest. Yeah, but we're not gonna deviate anywhere, let's just follow the main path. Huh? Star, my cameraman mentioned that the trees were marked red. Yeah, I wonder why. Should we go check it out? Let's go on an adventure!
As we were heading deeper and deeper into the jungle, suddenly the air felt heavier. Like it felt thicker, but at the same time very still. So I decided to take out my EMF reader.
Yeah. Oh! Huh! It was at 2 bars just now. We are in the thick of a forest right now. Feels very stuffy in here. It's blinking. Hi, thanks for touching this EMF reader. 3 bars? Wow, 3 bars, solid 3 bars right now. I'm guessing a tombstone is around here. Yes, three bars. Would you like to communicate further? Talk to us a little bit more? Yes? You can come close to this EMF reader for a yes, or move further away for a no, okay? Okay, yes. Are you a male or a female? Are you a male? Yes? Okay, let's try. Are you a female? Yes, too. It's both genders. We're about to head back out. Do you want us to go in deeper? No? Is there something dangerous inside? Okay, I'm gonna ask that again. Is there something dangerous inside? Do you want us to leave this place? You want us to leave? Do you want us to go in? And it's dead. Thank you for talking with us. Let's leave. Also, quick shout out to Nitecore. Thank you guys for supplying me with all these lights and stuff. Like, look at my headlamp. Boom! It's super bright, and this torch light is a freaking lightsaber, dude. Look at that. It's so strong. There's a promo code in the description if you guys want. Yeah, so I noticed that there are flags here. Can you see the flags? So we saw similar flags like this in the German girl shrine video. A lot of you pointed out that these flags are used to help guide spirits to the other realm. So thanks for that information, guys. Appreciate you. We found a caretaker's hut right there, deep in the forest. Who the hell would want to like chill here? Let's go see what the caretaker stored over here. Holy shit, wow, golf clubs. God damn, man's been playing golf in here. What the hell? What else we got? A lot of chairs everywhere. Containers. Yeah, just a bunch of junk. We just got out of that forested area. We are now on the main circle of Bukit Brown Cemetery. I still feel comfortable and fresh though. Why, you may ask? Oh, because of 1000 miles t-shirt and adaptive pants. Honestly, look at that stretch, man. Any spirits? Oh my god, wait, what? Hi, is anyone here? You have a very gorgeous grave. Oh. Yeah, your grave is really nice. We mean you no harm, just passing through. Just want to say hi. You touched this EMF just now. Could you come and touch it again for us? No? Can I come and check out your grave? Your tomb? It's so big and grandiose. Oh, look at that. There are even like lions at the side. Or is it dragons? Dragons? And two female carvings? Stone carvings? Anyone here? Anyone, anything? We mean you no harm. Just passing by. If you want to make your presence known, you can come and touch this device and it'll light up and we'll know that you're here. I'm just gonna wait a while. Sometimes it takes a while. You can come and approach this to make your presence known. This device right here. Yeah, are you capturing this? Can see a light? Yep. Thank you for making your presence known. Do you want us to stay? If you want us to stay, can you light this up again and we'll talk to you? Do you want us to stay? No? Make a sound somewhere, a knocking, a scratching. You can come and touch me, push me. You can come and touch me, make my goosebumps stand. If you would like to make your presence known, you can touch my cameraman. No? And it's gone. It's so weird, like just now, right after I said make your presence known, it immediately shot to 3 bars. As you can see, I'm very far away from everything. It's weirder in a cemetery because I know that there aren't any electrical wiring around here. Oh my god. I thought I saw someone standing there, but it was just the guard statues, if you guys can see. Yeah, so I thought those were people. Let's go have a closer look. So, this is a very famous tombstone. Hear music? Yeah. We hear music, and it's coming from there. Oh no, this is Pulau Ubin all over again. Fuck, man. Not backing out this time, I hope. Where? Huh? Where? From the grave? Holy shit! Music is coming from this flower. It's a speaker. What the hell? Wow. First of all, what an ingenious way. Second of all, does it not run on battery? This is the first time I've seen like music at a tombstone. So there are stories that say if you look the Sikh guard in the eye, it will blink at you. No, Nothing.
As we were exploring this grave, a couple of guys drove past us in their car, and they told us some very interesting things.
Yeah. Thanks, hey, take care. Someone said that there was a hut behind and people used to do black magic there, so we'll check it out later. Yeah, it's a popular cemetery. People come here and explore at night, even on a random Friday. Got my spirit box now. We're gonna see if there's anything here that wants to communicate. EMF is spiking. Talk to me through this spirit box. If there's anything you would like to say. I heard a female voice. Do you have a name? 3 bars now. There are just very faint voices here and there. I couldn't really hear. Let's head to the black magic place. Let's try to find that place, the place that the guy told us about. There's a shopping cart here. It's probably for offerings for that big grave over there. A bit irresponsible though to just leave the shopping cart here. But yeah, let's go check out this grave. This is a gigantic grave. Look at that. Wow. It's huge. I'm gonna leave the EMF reader right here by Kia Seng Huat's tomb. We have a very nice grave, very grand grave. Mr. Seng Huat, if you are still here, or anyone or anything, any entities, you can come and touch this EMF reader to let us know that you are here. EMF was blinking for a bit, it's quite intermittent. Again, right when we turn on the camera, the EMF stopped blinking. Can you come and touch it again, please? If you want to make your presence known, 如果这里有什么东西, how do I say spirits in Chinese? 你可以来碰这个东西, 还是碰我, 你可以碰我, 动我, I'm just gonna wait a little while longer. The EMF was at 3 bars just now. We invite anything, anyone, any spirits or entities to come, show us that you exist. EMF is spiking. 1 bar. Thank you for coming. Some of you mentioned that I should scold the spirits because apparently Asian spirits react better to aggressiveness. But I just don't want to be rude, you know. I demand you to touch this EMF reader. Touch it! Touch it! I feel like I'm just chasing it away. I think I'm gonna stick to being nice, for now.
So we finally found the hut where black magic was supposedly being done. And this was when I had my most baffling experience yet.
Let's try to go in. Looks like there's a lot of things in here. What the fuck? Oh, it's chickens. Oh, hi, sorry.
Sorry.
Get out. Do you see someone there? Got capture? Huh? Yeah, let's keep going.
So we saw a woman in a white dress inside this house. That sounds like a Pontianak. Why am I so happy? What the hell? Look at that face. Why is he smiling so hard? I'm gonna let Explorer Sushii explain what he saw.
I'm not sure if we captured it or not, but get a bit of goosebumps. Literally, when you saw the chickens, was it caught on camera? The chickens? The moment we saw chickens and when I started walking into that hut, I'm not joking, I swear guys on everything, me and Star, we saw a lady dressed in white just peek out of a, it seemed like there was a room inside. First thoughts, it looked human. It's probably just a woman staying in that hut. What is she doing in that hut, staying alone in a cemetery in this hour? I really don't know. What is she doing? Black magic perhaps? I don't know, but I didn't stay to find out because I was basically trespassing into someone's property and I didn't want to do that. I'm just looking at the road in case you just suddenly charge at us. Fuck man.
I'm gonna help this man elaborate the story a little bit better with my insane Photoshop skills. I scrubbed through every frame of footage I had and this is the best frame I got. But you still can't really see the figure in white. But this is where I saw the figure in white. She came out from behind a shelf or a cupboard. So behind the cupboard is actually a room, like you can turn in to the room. So I saw that figure in white just pop out from that room, and I gave a quick glance at her. Star, my cameraman, however, said he gave a good 3-second look, and he saw that it was a Malay woman with black long hair, wearing a white gown. I mean, who the hell dresses like that, and in a hut in a cemetery? My goodness. Yeah, I really didn't know what to make of that, but later on, we decided to head back to the house to confirm what we saw, and we actually found some answers.
The only thing I'm puzzled is why someone is staying there at this hour. But I'm feeling comfortable though, because I'm in 1000 miles ART and the adaptive pens. I'm supposed to do an ad read right now, but I'm a bit shooketh. Let's go further down, then I'll do the ad read. As I'm standing in front of the highway that caused a lot of the graves in Bukit Brown to be exhumed, let me tell you about the sponsor of today's video, 1000 Miles. I am still shooketh by seeing that witch, that the witch of Bukit Brown Cemetery. But you've seen me wearing this t-shirt throughout tonight's hike. I may be perspiring like a priest in a preschool, but I still smell great. Star, come smell me. Smelly?
Yeah.
Yes?
No,
didn't smell anything. Of course, because I'm wearing the Aero t-shirt by 1000 Miles, it helps you wick away sweat so that it's not wet, and it's anti-odor, so you stay smelling fresh throughout the day. I literally don't smell anything. I'm also wearing the OmniFlex adaptive pens. As you can see, I look sexy as hell. I just keep looking there because I'm just afraid that the witch will just charge over at us. I feel like I'm in L4D right now. And honestly, when I received these pants, I thought it was just a normal dress pants. But when I put it on, I'm not even kidding, it's super, super comfortable. That's why I'm even wearing it to a hike like this. It's no joke, it's really cooling. Honestly, very airy and comfortable. I may be wearing this while exploring a cemetery, but say I got a wedding to attend later, boom, I can just throw on these pants again and head to a wedding at 2 a.m. And boy, do I have a good deal for you guys. If you use this code, you get discounts off your 1000 Miles apparel. So if you are looking for light, comfortable, versatile apparel, I highly recommend 1000 Miles. Look at me. What? Witch! Just kidding, no witch. But I'm flexible because I have the OmniFlex adaptive pants. I saw a light in front. What does the sign say? What's that? There's light in front. Hi.
You want try?
Huh?
You want try? I open.
Open what?
What you call English? Originally, apa bahasa Inggris? Originally. You want try?
Try what?
I try push someone inside your body.
No.
You want try? You want try? Let's go. Take experience. And can I clean? No,
you Bomo or what?
No lah, Malaysian only.
Then how you know? How you know how to do that?
My teacher send to me. Macam got... originally apa lah? Originally dalam bahasa Inggeris apa?
Where are you going? Inside?
I go someone lah, but spirit is low lah.
Yeah, ni you never see anything lah?
Only touch only.
The house there, you got see people inside lah?
No, no people.
The house inside there, got people?
Oh, one? This is yeah, forest day. After then I go to walk, we have someone sit here, sleep.
Sleeping. Male?
Family.
I saw a young woman inside, white dress. Come out like that.
Oh, nice. Where?
The house. I don't know, looks like human, look like woman. What's your TikTok? What's
it? Adik Paranormal.
ADEQ? Paranormal. Yeah, this house. Inside there.
Alright.
The house got a woman inside.
Real people
staying. Because just
after
now
I look, I have a real people sit, a barbecue.
Here, inside this house?
Ah, inside the house.
Okay. All take right. Care. Nice meeting you, bye bye. Yeah, so he says apparently there's people staying in this hut. It explains a lot.
So apparently there's a family staying in this house within this forest cemetery. Why? If any one of you know of this, please let me know in the comments. Why are they staying here? Why were they having a barbecue in the middle of a cemetery? And why wasn't I invited? I had a fun time exploring Bukit Brown Cemetery. I felt like I was walking in a piece of history. The tombstones were amazing to look at, and I highly, highly recommend anyone to come here, in the day of course, to enjoy this place in its full glory. Thanks for watching, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys very soon. Bye.